So hello everyone, my name is Pranjali Pawar. Currently I am in my fourth year of engineering in computer science. Today I'm here to demonstrate my DMW project, which is called customer segmentation. So before going further for the project directly, I would really like to introduce you to what exactly customer segmentation means. So customer segmentation is, in simple words, division of different types of customer into various clusters or group. So we can apply different business strategies by using that data. So for better understanding, I'll take an example. Like we consider Amazon. So Amazon is an online e-commerce website which sells different kind of products to a huge range variety of customers. Like Amazon literally covers the globe for its selling, and everyone buys from Amazon. So it has a various range of customer types. So to identify most loyal customers, which customers are very like precisely prefer Amazon, that customers or some customers may be visiting the website, like if it is having its sale or something like that. So like considering like these categories, we are going to cluster or group up our customers into different types. So by seeing this picture, you can see if we consider this is the whole group of various kind of customer Amazon has, and we are going to separate them into different categories based on some factors which we'll discuss further. So we are going to group up them into like this, into clusters, and then we can apply business strategies which we'll discuss later. So what are the factors which we are going to use to divide the customers into different groups? So RFM modeling, it consists of three factors, which is recency, frequency, and monetary. So what is recency? So recency is how frequently customer has visited the website. Like how recently, like before a month or before a week, the customer has visited the website. This shows the connection of the customer with the website. Second factor is frequency. So frequency is how many times a customer visits a website. Like if we can consider a duration, then in that duration, how many times does a customer visits a website? Even if he or she doesn't buy anything, but he visits the website like to see some products, so it counts the frequency. Like we consider in a week he visits the website 7 times or 3 times. So the 7 time customer is more connected or more loyal to our website. Like this, these factor we are going to consider for grouping of customers. Third factor is monetary. So the overall spending a customer does on a website or for his shopping is the monetary. Like how much a customer is spending. If he is spending a great considerable amount, then he is categorized into a group which is more loyal to the website. Whereas if the total amount of a customer is very low, then we can consider him or her into a different category. So this is basically understanding of the project. So I will like to show you the code for the project. So these are some libraries which I have used here for data analyzation. So NumPy is a library of pandas which is used for mathematical calculations. Also pandas, which is for analytical data analysis and manipulation. Matplotlib is used for plotting statistical graphs. Also we are going to need date time, as I said, for the recency factor we are going to require the date time. Then coming next to the library is sklearn library. This is actually an ML library. It pre-processes the scale, or it is used for analyzing the data, clustering or classification. So next then we have here C5 cluster hierarchy, which is also used for hierarchical clustering. What is clustering and exactly what we are going to see, I will explain in further code. So the first step is to import our data. So here I have used an online retail data set which I have obtained from UCI ML Dispository. So from here I have taken my data set which I have imported here. So this is a small window to my data. We can see all the columns here, like invoice number, stock number, description, quantity, invoice data, unit price, customer ID, and country. So here we can see these are the different types of columns in my database. Here also we can see how many rows and columns are there. So the first step are basically pre-processing our data or cleaning our data to perform the operations on it. So first of all, I need to see if there is some null values in my data set. So to see if it is having any null values, and the total null values I'm going to use is null dot sum. So here the output we can see every column and the null values it is indicated. So only description and customer ID have null values, and we have a number here that this much null values are there. Even though description column we are not going to use it, though we need to clean our data and we are going to drop all the null values. So here we are going to use drop NA, so it will remove all the null values from the data set. So once we have done this, here again I have shown here what by applying is null and sum, we can see there is no null value in the data set. So we are like we can move forward now. A data cleaning step one is done. Now the next step is we don't directly, like we have seen here, we don't directly have a particular column where the total amount of spendings a customer is indicated. So to form like to take I have taken a revenue column. I'm going to create a new column in the data set which is called revenue, and it will have the total amount of spending a customer does, which we can calculate by quantity into unit price. So yeah, we can see here a new column is added to the data set, and it has the value in it, different values for different customers. So moving forward, the next step is we are going to, like here we can see, even though the number is same, like a customer can buy different type of like if this is a customer and he has bought these different kind of things. So every time the voice number is added, and every time we can see different revenue is added. Now we will need a particular monetary for a particular user. Here we can see there are multiple entries. So to sum up them together, we are going to use customer ID. So based on customer ID, it will group all the entries of this customer ID, add the revenue, and it will show us. So now here we can see every different customer ID has different revenue. So we have summed up all the revenue values of a particular customer into one. So moving forward, the same thing here is done for frequency. Now frequency is like, as I've mentioned before, how many times does a how frequently a customer visits our website. So as we can see, for a single user there are multiple entries in the data set. We are going to count the number of entries, and we are going to add it into invoice number. So here we can see I have done that. The next step is invoice date. So for the recency factor, we need to analyze the duration, how much a customer has visited the website or how many days before. So what we are going to do is, like if we take an example, a customer has visited the website on 5th of January, on 7th of January, and today is 9th of January. So what we are going to do is the maximum date minus the data set, whichever the data set the customer has. Like if we take example, the customer has visited on 7th January. So 7th January minus 5th of January will be stored in duration. Now the customer would have also visited the website on 3rd of January. So 7th January minus 3rd of January will also be stored. So here we can see the output. Now, even though the duration will be multiple, but we will need the minimum duration, like how recently, like 2 days before or 3 days before. Like if a customer has a duration 3 days and 2 days, but we are going to consider only 2 days. So for that, using minimum values of duration, we have taken those only value in duration and we have removed all other values. Now the next step is to create a merging of data where we will create columns as customer ID, revenue, frequency, and recency. So these are the factors based on which we are going to perform a clustering. So also for the duration, we are going to only need the days and we don't require the time. So by using dt.days, we are only going to like we are go only going to keep the days in this. And we are going to remove the time. So yeah, here we can see a result that revenue, frequency, and recency. It has frequency values, recency values, and revenue values. Now moving further, I have plotted some graphs here about the data of revenue, frequency, and recency. So this is for revenue, this is frequency, and recency. So the next step is removing the outliners. So what are outliners? Outliners are basically observations which are different from remaining data set. So here we can see these values or these values are like out of range of our data. Now if I consider an example, consider we have a data set of heights. So the height could not be 50 feet or like 0.1 feet. So these are wrong data set values. It is not in our range. So we need to remove this, and these are called outliners. So same goes for this data set also. We need to remove the outliners, and we need to for removing outliner, we have a standard method which is called as IQR. So we have performed this method in this set of instruction. So what it is basically, now we need to divide our data in quantile. So what is quantile? Quantile is like percentage only, but it considers data like 0.05 is 5% or 0.95 is 95% of data set. Like now here Q1 dot REV, we are going to put till 5% of data in Q1 and data till 95% in Q3. Then we are going to calculate the value for IQR. So basically this is the procedure which we need to follow for removing outliners in IQR method. Then to keep it in particular range, the values which are greater than RQI minus 1.5 into IQR and also in range which are less than R3 plus 1.5 into IQR. So this will perfectly keep our data into range. So basically in IQR method, we consider 75% of data, but I have considered here 95 to keep like most of the data and not to lose a great amount of data. So I've put here 95. So this will give me a particular range of data, and it will be like it will be good to perform data analysis on that data. So same for frequency and recency, we are going to perform the same operation and remove the outliners. So next step is scaling. So scaling is like we can see the revenue, frequency, and recency are in different scales. Like frequency is in different, here we can see point value, decimal values, and like they are not on the same scale. So by scaling them, by using standard scaler, we are going to scale them on a particular scale and bring them all on a same scale. So after scaling, we can see here there are different values, but they are on same scale based on same scale. So moving forward, by using direct libraries and linkage method as complete and metric this, we are going to plot a dendrogram. So what is a dendrogram? Dendrogram is basically a graph which does clustering until one observation is produced. Like it starts from a single value, then it clusters the most of like it has the most recent value next to it clusters it into one and forms one value. Then again it does it for every single value, and it forms different clusters together, and the clustering is done until we find one single cluster. So we can see here we have many small clusters here formed. Then these two clusters are merged, and here a single blue color one custom cluster is formed. So we are going to apply n clusters. Now we don't we now here clustering is done, but the number of clusters or number of types of group customers we have decided is 3. So here we will put cut three, and the clusters will be 3. So the next step is to show the data, and the data is divided into different kind of clusters. So this particular customer belongs to 0 cluster. So to make it more clear, I have plotted here graph, and now I'll explain what exactly we have done on the data. So this is cluster 0, this is 1 and 2. We'll take as type 0, type 1 and type 2 types of customers. So type 0 customers are those here the value of recency is more than 150, which means it has a very huge recency value, which indicates the customer has not visited the website for a very large of time period. While if we consider type 2 customers, they are very recent to the website and have been visited the website very recently. Same goes for the frequency. So the type 2 customers are very loyal one to the website. Like they are very frequently visiting our website, so it has a very great value. And as compared to that, type 2 customers are very less frequent to visit the website. Type 1 customers are like moderate. Here also we can see they're not that low recently visiting, but the value is surely greater than type 2. So the last one is the monetary. We can see the type 2 customers really spend a great amount on their shopping on the website, as compared the type 0 really spends a less amount. So yeah, so this data can be we have done data analysis. Now this data can be provided to different companies, and based on that they can really apply different kind of business strategies and analysis to apply on these customers. So if we consider if we submit this data to Amazon, so here it can clearly see which customers belong to type 2, and they can surely provide some discounts to this particular category or some Prime membership ship like thing. So like they are the most loyal customers to them, so they can have some benefits. And like by submitting this data, the companies don't have to apply same business strategy to all the customers. They can segregate different customers and see like what are the benefits for applying for type 1, type 2 or type 0. Whereas the type 0 customers, we can consider those customers which rarely visit the website, or if it is having a sale or something, then only they visit. So business strategies, maybe we can offer them some coupons or something so that they are more connected or visiting our website, so they can increase the they can increase the connection with the website. So yeah, we can apply that. And on first type of customer, we can have them like the advertisement like we use, we can show different type of customers which can engage them with the website more. So yeah, that is all about my project. Thank you.